is like spring is coming.
The weather's perfect. This is great. Awesome weather.
Well, spring officially begins 1 month from today, but you're getting a sneak preview this weekend in the eastern half of the nation. Wait until you get a load of which cities will be hitting the 60s, 70s, and even 80s.
But savor it while you can. Another big winter storm is brewing, and it could have multiple impacts. Everything from snow to ice to even big thunderstorms.
All of these wild temperature swings and winter storms are doing a real number on our roads. Potholes are multiplying fast. Learn just how hard hitting a pothole will hit you in the wallet and how you can minimize the damage right here, right now on Weekend Recharge. Hey there, good Saturday morning to you, and welcome to Weekend Recharge. I'm Paul Goodlow.
And I'm Jennifer Lopez. Maria LaRosso has the day off. Well, this is a winter that many of us are going to remember for years to come.
Yeah, you name it, we've had it. In fact, record warmth, record cold, and now pretty destructive winds. Check this out here. People in Chicago are still talking about this morning. Yesterday's vicious winds, even something as simple as walking, proved a challenge. Some people were nearly blown off their feet. A 73-mile-per-hour wind gust was clocked just 4 miles northeast of Chicago. O'Hare Airport reported a 62-mile-per-hour wind gust. Flights, of course, were delayed, even some canceled as well. Some skyscrapers, even construction sites, had to be evacuated from just for safety as well. And Jen, that was a big story yesterday.
It certainly was. Today, though, the winds are a lot lighter across much of the Midwest. In fact, across the country, we're seeing a weak system moving through the south and more moisture going across the northern plains. There's also one that we're watching over extreme northern New England. So although on the satellite picture, it may look a little bit busy, and we certainly have a lot of H's and L's planted across the country, but there's just not a lot of active weather coming from this system. In fact, the big story today is going to be the warmth right through the middle of the country. Anywhere from the Middle Plains all the way to the Midwest, we will find temperatures 10 to 20 degrees warmer than where they should be. Paul?
That's right. Not feeling like winter, feeling more like spring here. Spring fever spreading east this weekend. Dallas, highs and low 80s today. Temperatures nearly 20 degrees above average. Detroit flirting with 60 degrees today. That's also more than 20 above average. New York City flirting with 60 as well. That's about 15 degrees above average. So, yeah, let's talk about this warmth, because today will be the warmest day across much of the south and southern plains, as we have our jet stream kind of riding pretty high. And again, the jet stream generally, it divides cold from warm air, and much of the southern half of the nation enjoying mild air here. Tomorrow, we'll see a little bit cooler air move a little farther south, but overall, it's still going to stay above average for most of the nation here. And we're talking 10, 20, 30 degrees above average from the southwest to the southeast, even the mid-Atlantic and the northeast, where temperatures, again, pushing 15 degrees above average. Let's talk about the south right now. Look at this. OKC, 82 degrees, 81 in Dallas, 82 in San Antonio. These numbers, 20 to almost 30 degrees above average for today. Now, tomorrow's going to be a little bit cooler across the region, but before we get there, we're flirting with records here. A forecast in the mid-70s in Albuquerque, Midland, 86 degrees is close to our record here. Even Lubbock, 85 is a forecast, 82 is the record. We should probably shatter that by 2 or 3 degrees here. And then tomorrow, still above average, but still, I mean, a little bit cooler than today, talking about more 60s and 70s versus the widespread 80s. Even the Midwest here, we're talking temperatures in the 30s and 40s and 50s, where you should be in the 20s and 30s. But also St. Louis, 75 degrees today. Tomorrow, slightly cooler across the region. Temperatures cooling to the 50s in St. Louis, but even that is still above average. And still plenty of 30s and 40s, where you should be in the 20s and 30s this time of the year. But it's not just the Midwest and the central U.S., Jen. The Northeast also enjoying some pretty mild air.
Yeah, the temperature is a little bit higher than where they should be. In fact, right now in Boston, we're in the 40s. And typically, we get into the 40s for the end of the day. So some nice conditions across the majority of the country. And I think a lot of people well, hopefully will not be complaining too much when they walk outside and the temperatures just aren't bone-chilling cold. We have had a very weak small disturbance move through the northern New England area, but that one is going to continue to move away. So increasing sunshine around Plymouth for you with a 10-degree above average number of 51, 49 for you in Boston, and then we see 58 in Washington, D.C. So some beautiful weather for us as we cruise into the weekend here across much of the Northeast. And then we get into next week, and that's when we notice more rain coming in. So again, what a difference from just last weekend, where the temperatures on the 13th and 14th were only in the 20s and the teens. Well, again, we're going to continue that streak of above average readings here in New York as we go into this weekend. Again, New York expecting a high today of 58. We drop it a little bit tomorrow, but it's still going to be above that average high of 43 with the number around 50 for your Sunday. Paul?
Well, the question is, wintry or wet? That's a million-dollar question as a new storm takes shape for the East Coast. And we're actually following a couple models which are trying to get an agreement on what could happen across the eastern half or third of the nation as we head into next week. Let's take a look at some models we're watching here because, again, big difference between just some heavy rain and snow. So we're definitely watching our storm system this weekend bring us some rain showers across the southeast, and our cold air is trying to push southward. But what happens after this storm kind of exits the region, we have a secondary low start to develop, and that's the one that could have two different paths, and depending on how much cold air is in there, wildly different scenarios in terms of what happens. So again, we'll look at the U.S. model here. High pressure will slowly retreat. Again, that will allow some of the cold air to linger here as our second storm starts to act on that and move across the Ohio Valley. Now, again, this one has enough cold air. We have a decent winter event across the Great Lakes here, and then it moves across the interior of the Northeast, meaning mainly a rain event for the Northeast, but definitely some snow on the backside. Now, the European model, well, this has the high retreating a little bit faster, which means limited cold air here across the Great Lakes as our secondary storms starts to take shape and move across the Ohio Valley. That will bring a lot more warm air in play. Some snow on the backside for sure, but this is a wilder storm in terms of far more rain than our first storm. So again, our scenario is kind of a blend of those two. We're looking at definitely rain showers across the eastern third of the nation as we head towards Wednesday. Some of the higher elevations, the valley, seeing some snow, maybe some freezing rain, but a lot more rain across this region. And the backside will start seeing some snow as well. But this scenario calls for more of a bigger rain event as we head into the middle of next week. Jen?
Well, the most powerful storm on the planet is next on Weekend Recharge. Tropical Cyclone Winston breaking records as it sweeps across parts of the South Pacific. Next target on this dangerous storm is Fiji. We'll take a look at where Winston is heading.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your dermatologist about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
When someone's diagnosed with cancer, it's the most traumatic event they'll ever face in their lifetime.
Finally, the stress, confusion, anxiety, and depression that make cancer more destructive can be overcome. Introducing the CORE program from Reimagine.
I've had cancer 5 times. I knew things were going to get better as soon as I enrolled in the program.
Research shows that when people feel better emotionally, they have better health outcomes and survival rates.
Reimagine was able to demonstrate benefit to patients who are being supported by that program.
Reimagine's CORE program combines the convenience of online instruction with our specially trained, caring instructors with you throughout your journey to give you kindness and compassion found nowhere else.
They helped me thrive in the face of cancer, which without Reimagine, I don't know that I could have done that.
Call or go online now.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Currently in our area, 69 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, generally cloudy, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
The newsmakers, the power brokers, the candidates,
absolutely,
and the big personalities on today.
It's time.
Join our table. Hear it straight from the players.
Is that right?
And go inside the campaigns.
Hi, Governor.
In the race to the White House. Wake up to everything that counts. Only on today.
Pretty amazing here. A very dangerous cyclone is sweeping across parts of the South Pacific at this hour. Tropical cyclone Winston slammed into Fiji with powerful winds and torrential rain. The storm has broken records. It is now the strongest tropical cyclone on record in the Southern Hemisphere and the first Category 5 storm on record to actually hit the nation of Fiji. Now, before it hit Fiji, Winston pounded Tonga, then made a U-turn and sideswiped that island nation again. Let's talk about where this system is. And we're out here towards the Pacific, and it continues to move across the nation of Fiji, the largest island here. I think it's called Vitu Fanau, I believe. Again, made a glancing blow here earlier in the morning, our time. Again, talking during the day there on Saturday already. Winds 160 miles per hour, moving west at 18 miles per hour, and it continues to be a huge rain producer. Again, a lot of tall mountains here on the main island here, and that is going to cause big concerns with flooding and also mudslides as well. And in terms of where it's going to go from here, it has already started to weaken a little bit because of its interaction with land. It's moving west, and eventually it's going to move more towards the south. The farther south it goes, the cooler waters it will encounter and then slowly weaken as it continues to move on towards this coming week. Jen?
All right, what a difference a week makes, especially in the Northeast. As we look at Boston, we had lows last weekend well below zero. Negative four it got down to on Saturday, even colder on Sunday. But today, it will not even get below freezing. Should be a high of around 52 degrees today. We keep it above average for Sunday, then we drop off a little bit as we head into next week. But let's take a closer look at the dramatic temperature swings that the Northeast has been seeing. We'll look at New York from last Sunday. The morning low got down to 1 below zero. Well, today's high is expected to be close to 60 degrees. It should be beautiful across the Northeast with more sunshine and more nice warm temperatures. Again, all of the Northeast was dealing with that cold air last weekend, but this weekend we're starting off with 59 in Pittsburgh, a little bit cooler tomorrow with 48. Then we head into next week and we see those temperatures dropping down into the 40s. So again, a nice break from that cold air across much of the Northeast for today and also tomorrow. Looking at the current readings, again, New York already seeing some of that sunshine with a temperature right now of 45. Paul?
Well, don't you hate this? Hitting a pothole, it can definitely damage a car and also damage your wallet big time. In fact, a new AAA report says damage from potholes cost drivers across the country $3 billion every year. It also says 16 million drivers had car damage from potholes in the last 5 years. Now, John Nielsen, AAA Managing Director of Automotive Engineering and Repair, joins us now and says that these numbers are staggering. So, again, what is the big cost here about repairing cars from pothole damage?
Well, the cost to repair a pothole damage could be anything from $50 to replace a wheel weight, all the way up to thousands of dollars to replace suspension parts and brakes. So it can range a lot, but it can be very expensive.
Well, let's talk about that. Is there any ways that drivers can minimize the cost, basically minimizing the damage to their cars when, again, every year this time of the year, we start seeing more and more potholes form?
Well, so there's a couple of things that motorists can do. And the first is to make sure that they keep their tires properly inflated. Because if you think about it, that's really the bumper between your wheel and the pothole. So taking care of your tires is first. Everybody can do that and it will help. The next thing is slow down a little bit, leave a little bit more distance between you and the car in front of you so you can see the pothole. And then finally, if you're absolutely going to hit a pothole, slow down and right before you hit the pothole, straighten up your wheel, take your foot off the brakes to try to minimize any damage to the suspension.
Okay, let's say you actually do have some damage. What's the best way to kind of pick a repair shop that's not going to perhaps put you through the ringer in terms of getting your repairs done?
Well, we have AAA has an approved auto repair network that we inspect. There's more than 6,000 shops nationwide. And the benefit of that is really having a shop you can trust. So build a relationship with your shop, get to know them. If you don't have one, visit a AAA approved auto repair facility.
And these potholes is not only a problem for some of the snowier states across the north, but this is a problem across many of the lower 48 states.
You know, we think of potholes in the Northeast and the Mid-Atlantic region, but they're just as bad on the West Coast. So anyone can experience them. It's something that we all need to be aware of and take care of our cars and prevent hitting them.
Now, in terms of responsibility for potholes, we know we always see those crews out there trying to fix them. Any advice in terms of better places to drive versus worse places?
Well, you know, it really depends on the weather. You should know your roads that you drive on normally. High traffic areas tend to have more damage than low traffic areas.
All right. John Nielsen with AAA. Thank you very much for that information. Hey, coming back, we'll take a look at the weather for next week.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tire she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even when half-worn, it's still safe, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn. Building the only truck with the best fuel economy. An award-winning engine. You got that fire. And a 9,200-pound towing capacity takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Now get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
Nights at 6 on the Weather Channel.
Is it really true a normal bee lives 45 days, while a queen bee feeding off only royal jelly can live up to 5 years?
Yes, due to the rejuvenating properties of royal jelly.
Now available in Tio Nacho Younger Looking Shampoo, an invigorating blend that maximizes the antioxidant properties of royal jelly and natural extracts to reduce the appearance of gray damaged hair. Experience younger looking hair or your money back. Tio Nacho, the king of royal jelly.
Available at these stores.
Roger Brenway.
All stars.
Cut, 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 cut.
Sketch. Cut.
Stitch.
Walk.
Sketch.
Cut.
Trim.
Walk.
Sketching.
I feel
cut.
Stress.
Stress.
Panic.
This girl loves that dress.
New season. Roger Brenway.
All stars.
No freaking way.
Every man for himself.
Bell's knows Florida, and Bell's knows brands. Your favorite brands are in-store or online. Visit bellsflorida.com. Bell's, more brands, big savings.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop! Whoa! Whoa!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, people waking up this morning, firing up the chainsaws across the Midwest today to clean up from yesterday's powerful and damaging winds.
Yeah, Andrew Polano is showing us this huge tree that was split in half in Milwaukee yesterday. National Weather Service did clock 60-mile-an-hour winds in the downtown area. Even stronger winds, though, out at the airport with a gust up to 63.
Meanwhile, in Chicago, near hurricane-strength winds causing serious problems, gusts up to 62 miles per hour on Friday.
Yeah, just an incredible day. Damage reports from all over the city. Painted pictures of trees being knocked down, windows blown out because of the strong winds. Even buildings had to be evacuated because it just wasn't safe. It was especially difficult for people just trying to walk down the street. Watch as NBC Chicago's meteorologist Byron Miranda helps a woman that's getting blown away.
You want me to help you across the street? Whoa! Where are you going? Right there?
Come on. I don't think you can do it.
Huh? Maybe we should take you to the...
Yeah. Oh my God.
Hey, give me a hand, brother, get across. Hold on to it.
Got some Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts there, helping little old lady get into her taxi cab there. Look at these numbers here. Again, we're talking winds gusting close to hurricane force here around Chicago. Even Gary, Indiana, gusting to 70 miles per hour. O'Hare, 62 miles per hour. Now, the winds, really just one example of the extreme weather we saw this past week.
Yeah, we also had tornadoes, record freezes, and warmth. But Dave Malkoff explains why our weather in the U.S. is unlike anywhere else in the world.
How is it possible to have so many different kinds of weather going on at the same time in the same country? These are the weather alerts we've seen over the past several days. Basically, a little bit of everything, depending on where you live.
It is kind of exciting for meteorologists to see this.
We're lucky to have Dr. Greg Forbes and Tom Nizzle to explain it for us.
We have the Gulf of Mexico, we have the Pacific Ocean, and the Atlantic Ocean.
So I think what you're saying is the United States is not flat like this. It's got texture to it.
Oh yeah, it's not flat by any means, and in fact we all know when we take geography class that the United States has things called mountain ranges, and so what effectively does is it breaks the U.S. into thirds. In the western U.S. here, not a lot of cold air makes it down because the Rockies block that out. On the eastern side of the mountain, the Appalachians block most of the cold air, so it leaves the central U.S.
Wow, so this is all one section of the country that just gets all this air from the Gulf just pushed up into it, right?
Yeah, it sure does. Also has an unimpeded path here for the air from the Arctic to come down out of Canada.
There's right no mountains up here.
Nothing sitting here. This is all plains, so that Arctic air can meet all of that moisture out of the Gulf of Mexico, and you end up with either severe weather in the warm air or some major winter storms in the cold air.
And no other large countries on the planet are like the U.S. in that way.
There are some countries that get severe weather.
Our mountain ranges are north-south ranges.
So let's just play around, Tom. Let's pretend like we can peel the Rockies off of here and peel the Appalachians off of here and make a giant Himalayan mountain range here. What would happen to the United States if it had the Himalayas here.
Oh, yeah. It would cut off this major source of moisture that comes out of the Gulf of Mexico. It effectively would almost turn this area into a desert in some respects. And without that Gulf of Mexico moisture, nowhere near as much severe weather on the warm side. And certainly without the moisture, not much in the way of winter weather, just really cold here in the wintertime.
But that's not the way it is. We have one mountain range here and one mountain range there, so we have three separate countries going on at the same time.
And it makes the United States one of the greatest natural laboratories to study the weather on Earth.
See, boys and girls, there is a use for Play-Doh when become grown people.
Yes. Just got to make sure you put the lid back on once you're done with it.
Let's talk about the West Coast, because right now we're dealing with some rain showers and some scattered snow showers. Salt Lake, most of the heavier snow, maybe 2 or 3 inches, will be north of Interstate 80 today.
Yeah, but as we look at your forecast, we will get some breaks from the rain around Seattle with a little bit of sunshine trying to move in. Temperatures not bad in the 50s. Also more sunshine down into Northern California, where we did find some heavy rain in a few spots yesterday.
For Sunday, more rain approaching the West Coast, Pacific Northwest in particular, but more sunshine here in the interior. Yellowstone 30, Salt Lake City at 50 degrees for your Sunday afternoon.
All right, stay with us. We'll have much more right after this.
This just got interesting. Why pause to take a pill? Or stop to find a bathroom? Cialis for daily use is approved to treat both erectile dysfunction and the urinary symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently day or night. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medicines and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain or Adempas for pulmonary hypertension, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, get medical help right away for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or any symptoms of an allergic reaction, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis and a $200 savings card.
Whether it's snow, sand, or mud, there's only one way to keep your vehicle's floor perfectly protected all year long. WeatherTech Floor Liners. Laser measured to perfectly protect your specific vehicle, front, back, even up the sides. So what gets in the liner stays in the liner until you wash it away. Shop now at WeatherTech.com or call 1-800-CARMATS. WeatherTech, proudly made in America.
I've suffered for 18 years with dry, cracked hands.
In the winter in Chicago, it's dry, it's cold, makes my hands even worse.
O'Keefe's Working Hands, guaranteed relief for dry, cracked hands.
My hands feel better.
I finally found relief.
Learn more at O'Keefe'sCompany.com.
Have you tried O'Keefe's?
Love drama? Go on a first date.
My passion is puppetry. Here?
I think we're done here.
Hate drama? Go to cars.com. Research, price, find. Only cars.com helps you get the right car without all the drama.
Jet.com is here. The smart way to save on pretty much anything. It's the biggest thing in shopping since...
Where's the money?
Cash registers.
Sorcery.
With Jet.com, you can save on pretty much anything. It's the biggest thing in shopping since shopping.
If you're going to say better ingredients, better pizza, you better deliver. Which is why I'm introducing our new Papa John's Quality Guarantee. Love your pizza or get another one. Absolutely free.
Get any large pizza with up to 5 toppings for just $9.99. Online only
at PapaJohns.com.
Blizzard of 1978. The one moment that made me a weather geek. I mean, I just loved weather. I remember that night hearing all the warnings. Oh, blizzard coming, a lot of snow, blah, blah, blah. Looking out my front window, nothing. Go to bed. Wake up the next morning, poof, talking close to 2 feet of snow. Wow. I was hooked ever since.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight, low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies. High 76. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone, your premier hearing care partner.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
Okay,
you notice this. You can see the visibility go way down. The wind was going that way. And then you see some of the debris and the branches going another way.
God, if it's your will. And it turned, as I was saying.
As we're piling the snow up, it is adding up here in downtown Buffalo.
It is really going to go from a bad travel day to just a horrendous travel day.
Ago we were frozen like I don't know, and today it's rain like I don't know.
All right, that was this past week. What does next week have in store? We'll find out. Hey, it's half past the hour now as Weekend Recharge rolls on. I'm Paul Goodloe.
And I'm Jennifer Lopez. Maria LaRosa has the day off. It has been a wild roller coaster ride this winter. And that's going to continue as we move into the weekend. The big story are the temperatures, but they're going to be going up and then they go down as we head into next week.
In fact, coming up at 40 minutes past the hour, maybe you can actually can't get away from the beach this weekend, but Weekend Recharge can take you to the beautiful coastal state of South Carolina. We'll find out how tourism is bouncing back after devastating floods happened this fall. Jen?
Okay, let's talk about your forecast. And these are the things we're looking at. Big warm up this weekend. Chance for showers, though, in the south. And then all our eyes are going to focus on a new system brewing that's going to have an impact across the majority of the country for the start of next week. Temperatures nice and pleasant, close to 80 degrees this afternoon in Dallas. That wind dropping off for you around Chicago. You will be able to get out and enjoy it with the middle 50s around. Chance for a few showers. We'll watch those here mainly late tonight and into tomorrow across the Appalachians and through portions of the lower Mississippi Valley. And then we head into next week and we're talking about rain, maybe some snow coming to the East Coast. Paul?
Well, spring fever definitely trying to kick off this weekend. Take a live look at St. Louis in the upper left. You got D.C. in the upper right. And below center, you got the NYC. All areas enjoying some temperatures, some 10, 15 to 25 degrees above average for this time of the year. You got to remember, we're still talking, what, the 20th of February. Though I wouldn't say the depths of winter, but pretty solidly still cold in winter normally this time of the year. But our jet stream, which divides the cold air from the warm air, riding kind of high, which allowing the warm air to travel north in areas that typically doesn't see and experience this warm air on average this time of the year. Tomorrow, though, we see a little bit of a trough try to develop here, which definitely will limit some of the warmth for your Sunday, but hey, not today. Today should be the warmest day for a lot of people across much of the southern half of the nation, where temperatures running some 10 to 30 degrees above average. Texas, 80 in Dallas, 83 in San Antonio, 85 in Lubbock. Many of these numbers, 25 plus degrees above average, and also flirting with some records. Tomorrow, though, still above average, but maybe 5 to 15 versus a 20 to 25 degrees above average. The Midwest, we got temperatures today in the 30s and 40s, even some 50s, even 75 in St. Louis. That's 27 degrees above average. Although tomorrow, here's this little trough I'm talking about. Temperatures moderate and get closer to average or right around average. But again, St. Louis, we're closing in on 55. That's about 10 degrees above average. The warmth definitely here. The warmth also moving across parts of the Northeast as we head throughout this afternoon as well, Jen.
Yeah, we're loving it in the Northeast, especially compared to last weekend where the temperatures were just awful. Well, this weekend, we're starting off in a few 30s, but those numbers in Maine and northern New England, they'll start to go the other way. Temperatures right now in Boston in the middle 40s, also 40s for you in New York. We're going to see the clouds start to decrease, so that's really going to bump up the numbers as we head into the afternoon. Look here at Plymouth, 51 for an afternoon temperature. Also, D.C., Pittsburgh, great weather for you with high temperatures near 60 degrees. We even get the above average temperatures as we move into tomorrow. But tomorrow, if I had to take my pick, today would be the better of the days because tomorrow we'll notice the numbers drop off a little bit and increasing clouds, especially over the Virginias and through Pennsylvania. So we'll start to see a chance for some rain on the increase. Here we are in Buffalo, again, just awful over Valentine's weekend and President's Day weekend. Now those numbers much better with highs into the 40s and 30s. And these numbers are actually above average and they're going to stay that way for many places here across the Northeast. Paul?
All right, that's this weekend. What about next week? Well, we're kind of stuck between perhaps a wet system or a wintry system that we're watching to develop as we head across the East Coast next week. Let's talk about the players in play here in terms of our forecast. We have a first low. That's going to bring us some heavy rain, even severe weather potentially across the Southeast as we head towards the end of the weekend. But our jet stream allowing some cooler air to try to play into our second system. And this is the key. Does it move more towards the west or more towards the east? And that will be a big factor in who gets the snow and who gets more of the rain as well. Now, the U.S. model has this high pressure kind of slowly retreat here, which allows more of the colder air to stay in play as our second low starts working in here, feeding on this moisture. And again, you see the freezing line here. This could be a more impactful snow event across parts of the Great Lakes and eventually in towards the interior of the Northeast as we head on towards the middle of next week. Now, the European model, again, this has been all over the place the last couple of days. This morning, trying to come in line with close to what the U.S. model is doing, but it still takes this high a little faster out of here, which means we have less colder air, which will play into our second system initially, which means perhaps a wider area of seeing more rain than snow as we head on towards the middle of next week as well. So both storms will definitely need more rain, especially across the I-95 corridor. But the setup of where that snow and rain-snow mixture, maybe even some freezing rain and sleet will be, that is the factor that we still haven't worked out the for sure details on. Again, we still have about 4 or 5 days to iron this out, but definitely we do expect a more impactful rain event across the I-95 corridor. But again, where that snow will be a definitely concern as we try to fine-tune this forecast. And if it does get a name, the next name would be Petros. Jen?
Okay, up next on Weekend Recharge, a comeback story you're going to love. South Carolina took a major hit from historic flooding, but now the state is on the rebound. We'll talk more about this next.
Across America, people are taking charge of their type 2 diabetes with non-insulin Victoza.
For a while, I took a pill to lower my blood sugar, but it didn't get me to my goal. So I asked my doctor about Victoza. He said Victoza works differently than pills and comes in a pen.
Victoza is proven to lower blood sugar and A1C. It's taken once a day, anytime. Victoza is not for weight loss, but it may help you lose some weight. Victoza works with your body to lower blood sugar in 3 ways, in the stomach, the liver, and the pancreas.
Victoza is an injectable prescription medicine that may improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes when used with diet and exercise. It is not recommended as the first medication to treat diabetes and should not be used in people with type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Victoza has not been studied with mealtime insulin. Victoza is not insulin. Do not take Victoza if you have a personal or family history of medullary thyroid cancer, multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2, or if you are allergic to Victoza or any of its ingredients. Symptoms of a serious allergic reaction may include itching, rash, or difficulty breathing. Tell your doctor if you get a lump or swelling in your neck. Serious side effects may happen in people who take Victoza, including inflammation of the pancreas, pancreatitis. Stop taking Victoza and call your doctor right away if you have signs of pancreatitis, such as severe pain that will not go away in your abdomen or from your abdomen to your back, with or without vomiting. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you have any medical conditions. Taking Victoza with a sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar. The most common side effects are headache, nausea, diarrhea, and vomiting. Side effects can lead to dehydration, which may cause kidney problems.
If your pill isn't giving you the control you need, ask your doctor about non-insulin Victoza. It's covered by most health plans.
You know how it goes. You laugh. You tense. Your bladder contracts. You leak. Or you don't. New Poise Impressa Bladder Supports help stop leaks by supporting your body in just the right place. See why 9 of 10 women said their bladder leakage was reduced or stopped at Impressa.com.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
What a difference a week makes here in the Northeast as we look at New York last weekend, where the temperatures were just awful, really. Well below zero in the morning lows. Well, hey, this weekend, not too bad. Temperatures today expected to be up into the 50s here, and that is going to be almost 15 degrees above your average. Okay, let's have a look at the South. And again, the South was also impacted with that cold air last weekend. Charlotte, the Queen City, 30 degrees last weekend. Oh, tomorrow expected to be close to 70. So some nice weather is in store for not only the Northeast, but also the South, some of those warm temperatures. Here we are in Miami at 72. Tampa seeing some sunshine for spring training at 63. A little bit of fog, poor visibility right along the Gulf Coast. We've been monitoring that. That should slowly start to improve, though, around New Orleans. Otherwise, just some beautiful weather, temperatures up into the 50s, and the winds not that bad. All right, let's look ahead to the forecast. Here we go. We're going to bump these numbers up as we get into the afternoon. We keep the clouds, though, across the mid or the deep South, really. Little disturbance here that could bring a few scattered showers into Nashville. So all in all, not too bad. May find a few more showers by tomorrow night across the Southeast.
We're looking for a great place this weekend to spend. Well, here's a great idea. Head to gorgeous South Carolina. You're looking live at Myrtle Beach on the left and Charleston, South Carolina on the right, both enjoying a pretty mild Saturday and even Sunday as well.
Yeah, there is a campaign for the tourism to increase it across the Palmetto State after the state was hit with flooding over several communities last October. So joining us to talk more about the tourism is Dwayne Parrish. He is the director of tourism, and we appreciate you joining us. It looks beautiful behind you. Dwayne, how is your state? How did it get impacted, obviously, from the flooding back in the fall?
Well, it was a devastating flood, but the majority of the damage, the heavy damage, occurred in the middle part of the state, whereas our tourism areas along the coast received some minor damage, but a lot of cancellations. We took a big hit in October and parts of November from a business standpoint, but started a campaign called The Coast is Clear in the latter part of the year, and then rolled that into this year, and now our season's beginning, and so now it's a great time to come back, weather 70 degrees, and love to people have people here and great locations along the coast like you're showing now with Charleston and Myrtle Beach.
Well, Dwayne, how is the campaign, the tourism campaign you're running now, how has that helped with tourism in South Carolina?
It's helped tremendously. 2015, even despite the flood, was a record year. Gas prices are low. It's a great time for people to travel. And so we've actually had a very good year in 15, but certainly saw some of the damage from the floods. I expect a lot of the people who maybe canceled to rebook for this spring the spring is looking very good. Gas prices are still low, and we've got great places to come along the coast and other parts of the state.
Oh, I just love going to South Carolina, whether it's upstate South Carolina, up into the mountains, or even across the low country. Great, great places to go and see. Just if you had a quick trip to go there this weekend, what would be one spot to make sure that you wouldn't miss?
Gosh, Greenville, you just mentioned the lower part of the mountains, a great place to go. One of the most rejuvenated cities in the last 20 years in the Southeast. Wonderful down spot walking along Main Street there. Anywhere along the coast in the low country, all the way up to Myrtle Beach, great places in between, like Beaufort and Georgetown.
We used to vacation in Edisto Island. It was great.
Right. Great information. Thanks for joining us. That's Duane Parrish with the South Carolina Tourism Board. I got to say, some of the lowest gas prices in the Southeast
are
in South Carolina.
They really are. And I'm sure you've golfed there a few times.
I have a few times.
Yeah, just a
great
few
golf.
Times. All right, we may see a few showers, though, over the weekend coming into the Southeast. Not so much of a big deal today. Tomorrow, though, we're expecting that rain to move in, kind of that front just sitting up through the Tennessee Valley. That's going to keep the instability around.
Right, a better chance of showers across areas of Tennessee tonight. But the Carolinas, especially South Carolina, the upstate, could see a few showers. But the coast, as they say, coast is clear as we head on towards your Sunday afternoon. Sunday night, could see some clouds leading to some showers. Definitely a better chance of rain as we head towards Monday across much of the Southeast, including the risk of thunderstorms. Some of the heavier rain will be towards the lower Mississippi River Valley.
All right, well, straight ahead, we have a very powerful tropical cyclone down in the southern hemisphere. We're going to talk more about this storm coming up.
Miss Founders Days at Pep Boys. Get $40 off any brake service package starting at $99.99 after mail-in rebate. And when you buy three select tires, you get the fourth free instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
I did it. I joined eHarmony. Yeah, I can get my own dates.
How's that going?
Sign me up.
Stop waiting. Start communicating for free today.
Everyone's looking red carpet ready. My man, let me guess who you're wearing.
Toenail fungus.
What?
Fight it with Jublia. Jublia is a prescription medicine used to treat toenail fungus. Use Jublia as instructed by your doctor.
Jublia is working it.
Most common side effects include ingrown toenail, application site redness, itching, swelling, burning or stinging, blisters, and pain.
Oh!
Fight it with Jublia.
Now that's a red carpet moment. Ask your doctor if Jublia is right for you.
Visit our website for savings on larger size.
Building the only trucks with the best fuel economy. Best towing. Best torque. And best payload. Takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle. That's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to $2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop! Go! Go!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Are you in chronic pain or want to avoid surgery? At Stem Cell Centers of America, now in Boca Raton, our state-of-the-art Max Stem procedure allows us to take your body's own healing cells and move them directly to the source of your pain and discomfort, all without invasive surgery. Call now to schedule a free, no-obligation consultation with Dr. Perita.
My pain is gone.
And I have my husband back.
Discover how Stem Cell Centers of America can help you to live a more active lifestyle.
Attention business owners, get faster internet with the Comcast Business Switch and Save event. Call 800-501-6000 for fast 25 megabits per second internet at 30% off the regular price. Just $69.95 per month, our lowest price of the year. But hurry, this special offer ends soon. Call now and you'll also get our no-glitch switch. Choose your installation time, days, nights, even weekends. Then we'll install in about an hour. Save 30% with the Comcast Business Switch and Save event. Call 800-501-6000 now.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. tonight. Partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies. High 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
A very dangerous storm is sweeping across parts of the South Pacific at this hour. Tropical Cyclone Winston slammed into Fiji with powerful winds and torrential rain. The storm has broken the records. It is now the strongest tropical cyclone on record in the Southern Hemisphere. It's the first Category 5 storm to hit Fiji. But before it came into Fiji, Winston pounded Tonga, then made a U-turn and sideswiped that island nation again. Well, let's give you the latest look. The cyclone showing up very well on the satellite picture as it moved across the island nations, or the island nation of Fiji. Again, it's made up of several hundred islands. Wind still very strong at 160 miles an hour. It is going to be moving to the west, so it'll take it away from Fiji. It is expected to weaken a little bit and then kind of move towards the south. Here's the latest look at the radar, still showing a few showers, especially across the bigger island to the south. But again, the projected path, taking it in more of a less of a south direction, so it keeps it in the open waters, not expected to have an impact on Australia or any of the islands to the east of Australia here as we go through the weekend. Paul?
All right, back here at Stateside, watching what's going to happen as we head through this coming week and potentially another winter storm. Right now, we're watching our first storm across the southeast. The good news is we're expecting this to be stronger. This first low will not be, so we don't expect as widespread severe weather concern across the southeast, at least on Tuesday, maybe Thursday, different story with our second low. So we're watching this definitely kind of slide out to the east. A secondary low will develop. This one has a better chance of giving more severe weather as we head towards the middle of this coming week. And again, does it move more towards the interior or more out to sea? Has a big impact in what happens here across the eastern half of the nation. So we look at the U.S. model here first, and high pressure will kind of slowly retreat across the Great Lakes and the northeast New England, but it does allow enough cold air for our second low to feed on, and that will bring perhaps a more impactful snow event across areas of the Midwest and across the Great Lakes into the Northeast as well as Ohio Valley. Again, this model has been kind of flip-flopping from time to time as well, so these models aren't in total agreement what's going to go on. So in fact, the Vortmax here, we can see this with the up-level spin here. We clearly see with this second low a lot more energy kind of diving across the southeast. That will give us more energy for severe weather as we head on towards Wednesday and Thursday across the southeast. So even though it's still winter, we can still have severe weather. Now, the European model takes this high and moves it out a little faster, which means when our second low comes along, it has less cold air. Still some cold air, but not as much as the American model. And that will bring a lot more rain across much of the Ohio Valley and even the Great Lakes, as snow did with the American model. Definitely a concern here. But overall, we do expect more rain, even some thunderstorms Wednesday night and Thursday across the southeast. But also, we still expect some snow on the backside of this system.
From the moment they wake up, doers don't stop. Every day is a chance to do something great. And for the ones they love, they do anything. Sears Optical has glasses made for doing. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
If you take multiple medications, a dry mouth can be a common side effect. That's why there's Biotene. It comes in oral rinse, spray, or gel. So there's moisturizing relief for everyone. Biotene. For people who suffer from a dry mouth.
Lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Shakes. Replace a meal with one of four delicious new flavors, like creamy chocolate. With 20 grams of protein, 1 gram of sugar, and 100% daily fiber. Slim Fast Advanced Shakes. It's your thing.
When someone's diagnosed with cancer, it's the most traumatic event they'll ever face in their lifetime.
Finally, the stress, confusion, anxiety, and depression that make cancer more destructive can be overcome. Introducing the CORE program from Reimagine.
I've had cancer 5 times. I knew things were going to get better as soon as I enrolled in the program.
Research shows that when people feel better emotionally, they have better health outcomes and survival rates.
Reimagine was able to demonstrate benefit to patients
who are being supported by that program.
Reimagine's core program combines the convenience of online instruction with our specially trained, caring instructors with you throughout your journey to give you kindness and compassion found nowhere else.
They help me thrive in the face of cancer, which without Reimagine, I don't know that I could have done that.
Call or go online now.
They say you shouldn't spoil your kids, but your grandkids? How about front row seats to the best show in town? And that is why you invest. The best returns aren't just measured in dollars. TD Ameritrade.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Let me get you ready for the day weather-wise.
We've got a lot going on this morning.
Definitely see what kind of pattern we've had.
So start your morning routine with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jan Carfagna, and the rest of AMHQ.
It is a team here at the Weather Channel and an awesome team at that.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Well, good morning, Daytona Beach. A lot of people here in town for tomorrow's big NASCAR race and enjoying mostly sunny skies today. Look for a high to get towards 72 degrees. In fact, let's take a look at the forecast for the NASCAR event.
All right, let's have a look at your forecast. And we do call for maybe a few more clouds to be on the increase. Sounds like a bee in my ear or something. The temperatures, though, pleasant with the middle 70s in the forecast and not looking at a chance of rain.
Nothing but racing. Good racing weather. Race car. All right, hey, snow is one thing we guard against in winter. Cold is another.
So how do animals adapt to both? Well, that is one of the wonders of winter, as Jen Carfagno shows us.
We humans bundle up, heat our homes, and drink hot chocolate to stay warm during winter. But how do animals survive out in the elements? Well, they either hibernate, migrate, or adapt. Hibernation is like a very deep, prolonged sleep during which the body saves energy by reducing its temperature and heart rate. Some hibernating animals maintain body temperatures near freezing and reduce their metabolism by 75%. Animals such as bears, bats, skunks, snakes, and even bees hibernate to survive the cold months of winter. Ever wonder why humans who head to Florida for the winter are called snowbirds? Well, many birds, fish, elk, and other animals travel to places for the winter where they can stay warm and find food more easily. Some animals stay put and stay active during the winter. They simply adapt to their conditions. For example, weasels and snowshoe rabbits grow new, thicker fur that helps them keep warm and hide them from predators in the snow. Other animals stockpile food in warmer months, go underground or inside trees to stay warm, even huddle close together to save body heat. Aren't we humans lucky that we found our own ways to adapt? Stay warm this winter.
All right, now we know where the weasel goes.
We definitely know that you go south for the winter.
I do.
You do not like the cold.
I don't at all.
Hey, but again, will winter finally end? We do have a warming trend on the way. We'll talk about how warm will be in your backyard coming up.
And we also have a powerful tropical cyclone. We'll tell you where next.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest lasting Energizer Max ever.
Love drama? Go on a first date.
My passion is puppetry. Here?
I think we're done here.
Hate drama? Go to cars.com. Research, price, find. Only cars.com helps you get the right car without all the drama.
I've always been protective of my little sister. But when she got cancer, she was a strong one. She learned while she needed chemo.
It could weaken my immune system.
But then you found out about Neulasta.
Right.
Neulasta helps reduce infection risk by boosting your white blood cell count, which strengthens your immune system. In a key study, Neulasta reduced the risk of infection from 17% to 1%, a 94% decrease. Neulasta is for certain cancer patients receiving strong chemotherapy. Do not take Neulasta if you're allergic to Neulasta or Neupogen. Ruptured spleen, sometimes fatal, as well as serious lung problems, allergic reactions, kidney injuries, and capillary leak syndrome have occurred. Report abdominal or shoulder tip pain, trouble breathing, allergic reactions, puffiness in face or ankles, change in urine, swelling of stomach area, feeling of fullness, dizziness, or feeling faint to your doctor right away. In patients with sickle cell disorders, serious, sometimes fatal crises can occur. The most common side effect is bone and muscle ache.
Ellie's strong, but she still needs help.
Yeah, I do.
Ask your doctor about Neulasta.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Today feels like spring is coming.
The weather's perfect. This is great. Awesome weather.
Well, spring officially begins 1 month from today, but you're getting a special sneak preview this weekend of the eastern half of the nation. Wait until you get a load of which cities will be hitting the 60s, the 70s, and even 80s.
But savor it while you can. Another big winter storm is brewing, and it could have a lot of impacts on you. Everything from snow to ice to even big thunderstorms.
All of these wild temperature swings plus snow and ice are doing a real number on our homes this winter. The beating your house is taking from the weather and the steps you can take to protect it right here, right now on Weekend Recharge. Hey there, good Saturday morning to you, and welcome to Weekend Recharge. I'm Paul Goodloe.
And I'm Jennifer Lopez. Maria La Rosa has the day off, and this winter is one that a lot of people are going to remember for years to come.
Yeah, you name it, we've had it. Record warmth, record cold, and now pretty destructive winds. Got to check this out. People in Chicago, well, they're still talking about this morning about yesterday's vicious winds. The city's fire department evacuated several buildings on North Wacker Drive. Windows were blown out, sending glass raining down on the street below, and some of the buildings were construction sites as well. A 73-mile-per-hour wind gust was clocked just 4 miles northeast of Chicago. Midway Airport reported a 61-mile-per-hour wind gust. The good news, Jen, is the winds have pretty much died down now.
Yeah, that's storm system is moving out of there. It's pushing into eastern Canada. It has been bringing a little bit of light snow across northern New England. Elsewhere across the country, a few clouds going across the Tennessee Valley. But all in all, the big news this weekend is going to be the nice warm-up. It may look busy on this map, but it should be nice and quiet for you throughout today. We are expecting temperatures anywhere from 10 to 20 degrees above average, and it's going to be right in the middle of the country, stretching all the way towards the East Coast. Paul?
Speaking of warmth, spring fever spreading east this weekend. Dallas, look for your highs and low 80s today. It's about 20 degrees above average. Motown floating with 60 degrees today, more than 20 degrees above average. And the NYC also floating with 60 degrees today. It's more than 15 degrees above average. And especially if you consider how cold it was last weekend, what a difference a week makes. And for sure, we're looking at our jet stream, a big player in terms of this warmth. It is kind of riding to the north, which allows the warm air to come northward and keeps the colder air a little farther north. And again, enjoy today. Today should be the warmest day, especially across the southeast and southern plains, as our jet stream will kind of slowly kind of dip a little bit more as we head towards your Sunday. So it cools down a few degrees, but still widespread temperatures stay above average even tomorrow. But today should be the warmest, 10, 20, 30 degrees above average from the southwest to the southeast as well. And temperatures today in the 80s this afternoon. And yeah, we're talking floating with records as well. Tomorrow, maybe a few degrees cooler, but still plenty of 70s where you should be in the 50s and 60s this time of the year. Records, here we go. Lubbock, 86 is the forecast. 82 is the old record. We'll probably shadow that. Even Albuquerque, 74 is the old record. 75 is the forecast for this afternoon. But even the Midwest. Western Great Lakes. After the wind yesterday in Chicago, today close to 20 degrees above average, 56 degrees. But look at St. Louis, 27 above average, 75 for your high today, and 40 in Minneapolis. But also, like the Southern Plains, today is the warmest day. Tomorrow, temperatures cooler, back down to average here across the Twin Cities and Traverse City. But also St. Louis, go from the mid-70s to the mid-50s as we head on towards your Sunday afternoon. But again, we should still stay above average as we head into next week as well. So again, Jen, not only across the Midwest and the Southern U.S., the Northeast also warm today.
Yeah, a lot of folks smiling as they wake up this morning, and temperatures are actually warmer than the afternoon highs. Let's look at the current readings. 49 for you in New York. Typically, you should only get into the 40s and then stop. But today, that's not going to be the case. We're going to see these numbers really climb. We do have some of that colder air still kind of stuck across northern New England, and that's where we've even noticed a few light snow showers. Those should be moving on out. Notice the red triangles. They're all indicating temperatures anywhere from 10 to 15 degrees above average. Today is the day, folks. Get outside, do something, okay? Because tomorrow, it's going to be nice tomorrow still, but the temperatures are going to be a little bit cooler as we move into Sunday. We drop it down a few degrees here in Boston, still above average, but the high of just 49, and we're still close to 60 in DC, but we're not actually in the 60s. So if I have to be picky, today is the day, the better one out of the weekend. And then as we head into next week is when we'll start to see some rain and maybe some snow move in here. Let's talk more about that with Paul.
Yeah, that's the million-dollar question. Will our next winter storm be more of a wintry one or more of a wet one as well? So let's take a look at the players that we have in play. Then our models are not in total agreement yet. But right now, we definitely do know our first surface low kind of moves on through. It gives us some rain showers to end the weekend. But it's our second lower watching, which in terms of how much cold air it has to play with and also which track does it take, a more western track or more eastern track, has a huge influence on what we see and experience across the eastern half of the nation as we head towards, say, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday of this coming week. So scenario number one here with the U.S. model has high pressure kind of slowly retreating across the Northeast, which means it'll still linger some cold air in place to work with our second low, and that will bring more impactful wintry weather across a good chunk of the Great Lakes in the Midwest here, and that moves across the Ohio Valley interior of the Northeast as we head on towards Wednesday, Thursday of this coming week. Now, the next model is the European model. This is a little more quicker with the high pressure. It moves it out a little faster, which means not as much cold air in play with our second low storm developing. So again, that means a far more wetter system, more rain that will impact parts of the Ohio Valley and definitely the Northeast as we head on towards the middle and latter part of next week. But that's the big player in terms of where this storm goes, a little farther east, a little farther west, more cold air, less cold air. But the bottom line is we do expect a lot more rain across the eastern half of the nation, especially the I-95 corridor. Now, the interior, Ohio Valley, Midwest, again, we do expect some snow, but it's a big question mark of how much, depending on which model can handle this a little bit better. Again, the models have not been in total agreement and been all over the place with the storm system. So let me tell you, this take this with a huge grain of salt in terms of who will see what as we head throughout the week. But if this does get more impactful in terms of a winter weather standpoint, the next name will be our 16th named storm. That would be Petros. But again, the models have yet to come in agreement. This might be a thing that we really fine-tune on Tuesday versus previous storms we've got several days out. Jen?
The most powerful storm on the planet is next on Weekend Recharge. Tropical Cyclone Winston breaking records as it sweeps across the South Pacific. We'll tell you which nation it has been targeting.
I grew up in a neighborhood where being tough was more important than being educated. When Amy Lee came along, I knew immediately that I had to give her something different than what I had. I don't want her to go to school and be the only kid that doesn't know how to do the alphabet or how to count. I had to find something to help me help my daughter. With abcmouse.com, it was an instant change from frustration to fun and learning. She's learning so much so quickly. Within a few weeks, she was learning how to read. She was learning animals. She was coloring and learning about science. It's a full spectrum of knowledge matched with the fun of playing games. And then I don't have to be a teacher. I just have to be her dad. And that's what I'm good at doing. And I know that when she gets into school, she is going to excel. I have that confidence. She has that confidence. That came from abcmouse.com.
Life as a spokesbox is great. People love me for saving them over half a grand when they switched to Progressive. So I'm dabbling in new ventures. It was board game night with a Dalai Lama. Great guy, terrible player. Go paperless, don't stress, girl. I got the discounts that you need. Safe drive. It's a balancing act, but I gotta give the people what they want. More box.
Any words for the critics?
What can I say? Critty's gonna nag.
What?
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Hey, check this out. A very dangerous and powerful cyclone at this hour slamming portions of Fiji. This is Tropical Cyclone Winston slamming into Fiji with powerful winds, torrential rain. The storm broken records. It is now the strongest tropical cyclone on record in the southern hemisphere and the first Category 5 storm on record to hit Fiji. Now, before it hit Fiji, Winston pounded Tonga and made a U-turn and sideswiped that island nation again. And right now, it has already made landfall yesterday in Fiji. Now it continued to hit the largest island here in Fiji. Again, the capital, Sava, is on the south side of that. But still, they had quite a bit of activity with this system. And it continues to move westward here at 18 miles per hour. Sustained winds 160 miles per hour. So that's the equivalent of a Category 5 hurricane here in the U.S. And this storm has definitely done quite a bit of damage already. In fact, the last radar loop, it showed it pretty close to still that western island, edge of the island there. And again, the forecast for it to slowly weaken as it moves more towards the south, but it should be pulling away from land and should weaken over the next several days. Jen?
Well, what a difference a week makes here in the Northeast. Yes, let's look at Boston, for example. 4 degrees below zero was the low last Saturday morning. 9 below zero, a record on Sunday. Then we fast forward to today, and the forecast calling for today up to 52, tomorrow 49 degrees. A dramatic comparison to the temperatures from previous weekend to what we're expecting today. And again, New York down to 1 below zero on Sunday, and then we're getting up to 57 degrees for today. So some nice weather to look forward to, and you certainly deserve it across the Northeast after all of those cold conditions that we've had over President's Day and Valentine's Day weekend. Well, let's look at to Cleveland, expecting nice temperatures today for 59. We drop a little bit though on Sunday, and we keep those numbers closer to average as we go through the rest of this week. So that's why you really want to get out there today and try to do something outside and try to enjoy it, because we've had one weak system that's brought a little bit of light snow into northern New England. That's going to continue to move away from Maine. We'll find those south winds, breezy at times, but it's bringing in the mild air up to 60 in Philly, also in the 60s for you in Washington, D.C. Paul?
What kind of recent drastic temperature changes affect the interior and exterior of your home? Well, the answer is yes, and we want to know just how. Well, Robert Kreisner is the professional remodeler and joins us now via Skype. Good morning, Robert. Thanks for joining us. So what issues arise when your home is dealing with bitter cold one week and then very warm temperatures the next?
Well, Paul, one of the ones we look for is if somebody goes out there and washes their car with the day and then it goes down to freezing at night, make sure you disconnect that hose because it holds that water up against the valve and then they both tend to freeze, and we don't want you to have to call that plumber.
Good idea there. And also, what about the roof? The attic as well can be susceptible to problems with these temperature shifts as well, right?
Well, the attic in particular, you want to make sure that you don't have anything venting humid air out of the house, like a dryer vent or a fan out of your shower bathroom. Because that humid air, when it's get caught in the attic, and then you have snow on the roof, all kinds of condensation starts to form on the nail heads. It looks like rain in the attic. So you need to make sure that attic's well ventilated and make sure that humid air is getting ducted to the outside, not in there.
All right, what about the basement during these temperature changes?
Same concerns, and they keep the humid air out of there. And also make sure that if you have a sump pump, something to drain the water out of that basement, make sure that's clear and free of any debris so that it works when you need it. When that snow starts to melt, you want that water to be able to get out of there.
All right, great tips. That's Robert Kreisner, a remodeler there in Newport News, Virginia. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Paul.
We're also watching areas we're dealing with a big temperature change. Jen has more on that.
Yeah, temperatures are going to continue to stay nice and mild across the middle of the country. In fact, Texas, the state, could see temperatures 20 degrees warmer than average with those high numbers up into the 80s. And big changes for you in Chicago. You're finally catching a break from those damaging winds yesterday. This is how it was for you just to get outside and try to walk on the sidewalk. This lady's actually trying to get to her car, a cab there. She is being helped by several people, but it was very hard just to even walk up and down the street. Streets were even closed at times overnight because of the strong winds. Well, the winds are a lot lighter here today, so that is some good news. And powerful storms also could rumble through parts of the country early next week. In fact, Florida, you could be in the danger zone. So we're going to detail your forecast with the next system that we're looking at coming into this area. All right, let's head into Atlanta and get a look at some of the overcast skies here. But again, nice weather with the temperatures. May see a few showers as we move into the very end of the weekend, and also rain in the forecast for next week. We'll look at your forecast coming up in a few minutes.
Building the only trucks with the best fuel economy, best towing, best torque, best payload takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
You can't always protect her. Make sure her tires will. The Michelin Premier Tire with Evergrip technology. Even when half worn, it's still safe. Safe when new, safe when worn.
When you're living with diabetes, Steady is exciting. Only Glucerna has Carb Steady, clinically proven to help minimize blood sugar spikes. So you stay steady ahead.
You have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week. AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
With the pain and swelling of my moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis, ordinary objects often seemed intimidating.
Doing something simple meant enduring a lot of pain.
If RA is changing your view of everyday things, Orencia may help. Orencia works differently by targeting a source of RA early in the inflammation process. For many, Orencia provides long-term relief of RA symptoms. It's helped new RA patients and those not helped enough by other treatments. Do not take Orencia with another biologic medicine for RA due to an increased risk of serious infection. Serious side effects can occur, including fatal infections. Cases of lymphoma and lung cancer have been reported. Tell your doctor if you're prone to or have any infection like an open sore, the flu, or a history of COPD, a chronic lung disease. Orencia may worsen your COPD. If you're not getting the relief you need, ask your doctor about Orencia. Orencia. See your RA in a different way.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling. Stop!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight, low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Take a look at this. Yeah, cleanup from powerful winds yesterday across this area.
Yeah, Debbie Grossman showing us this huge tree that came crashing down in her backyard yesterday. She lives in Fox Lake, Illinois, just over 50 miles to the northwest of Chicago. Winds were up to 73 miles an hour, just northeast of downtown Chicago.
Meanwhile, in Chicago, look at this. I mean, near hurricane strength winds caused a lot of problems across the city, gusting up to 62 miles per hour officially at O'Hare Airport on Friday.
Yeah, a lot of damage reports coming in all over the city of trees just being knocked down, windows being blown out, also some buildings just being closed or evacuated because of the strong winds. It was certainly difficult for people to try to get out there and even walk across the street. Here is NBC Chicago meteorologist Byron Miranda as he tries to help a lady getting blown away.
You want me to help you across the street? Whoa! Where are you going? Right there?
I don't think you can do it.
Huh? Maybe we should take you to the
cab. I didn't need a cab.
The cab, yeah.
Oh my God.
Hey, give me a hand, brother, get across. Hold on to it. There you go. Thank you. Thank you.
Four people it took to help her get in that car.
Yep.
Just amazing with those winds. Well, at least the winds are gone, and we're actually enjoying some beautiful weather across Chicago, up to the 50s today.
And this weekend, definitely a warm day across much of the Midwest, the Southern Plains, the Northeast as well. Temperatures 10, 20, 30 degrees above average. Even the Southwest, Phoenix, 86 today. Tomorrow, Still above average, but not nearly as warm. Again, go from the 80s to 73 in Dallas. Chicago, 50s today, 39 tomorrow.
Back to reality.
And more rain showers, even some scattered showers and thunderstorms across portions of the Mid-South. 70, though, in Atlanta.
Yeah, we're also expecting more rain to move into the Pacific Northwest. A new system coming in. So Seattle, those showers should taper off today. And then we're going to get another round as we move into the end of the weekend. Now, starting next week is when we really focus in first on the South and then on the entire East Coast.
Yeah, let's take it to Atlanta right now, where your Saturday and Sunday on the warm side. Some hazy sunshine trying to break out there, but as we head towards Monday, back to school for some kids who are off for President's Week, we got rain showers here at the bus stop, both coming and going to school. And again, temperatures still mild. And again, average this time of the year is the upper 50s. We'll push the low 60s as we head on towards Monday afternoon.
And that's just Monday. We could be looking at chances for rain, maybe Tuesday, maybe even Wednesday. And talking about this system still on the Thursday time frame. So again, on Tuesday, we see another piece of it kind of coming down into the southern plains. That's going to have an impact in Dallas, bringing you a chance for rain, and also into Oklahoma City. And that rain just continuing for the southeast. But then on into Wednesday, we start to watch here across the backside of it. We'll see some of that colder air go through the Midwest.
We've been talking about this system because the models are still kind of not in total agreement. It's taken them a long time to kind of get a hold of the system, but we do know we do expect a lot more rain with this system. But again, the backside of exactly where and how much snow will be on the cold side of the storm is something we'll still fine-tune as we head through this weekend and into next week as well. Places like Cleveland, take a live look right now. We're also watching the possibility of some maybe rain, snow as we head towards, say, Wednesday of next week. But right now, we're in the 50s and some sunshine there. But again, take that forecast with a grain of salt here, that Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we could see more rain or more snow. Again, this is what we're trying to fine-tune. So don't bet the bank on this forecast right now. Again, this is a very tricky forecast. Mm-hmm. Again, we're in this transitional time with more warmer air, more energy. It kind of does a number on the models right now.
Yeah, so again, enjoy today because things are definitely going to change, at least just what kind of precipitation we will get and how much we will see. Now, as we go into Thursday, we do expect some of that rain to move up into New England. Again, your temperatures in Boston starting out in the 40s, also rain for you in New York. It's to the west, the inland areas that we're going to have to keep an eye on.
Let's move on towards the end of the week, Friday. As we do know, the system will be exiting cool air typically behind this. So look for some snow showers, maybe some lake effect snow as well. But overall, kind of a cooling trend behind this system, at least in the eastern half of the nation, while the west still stays mild. 87 in Phoenix, 82 in LA, and even close to 70 in San Francisco.
All right. Well, two brothers have set out to get people excited about going to America's national parks.
Coming up, we'll talk to the filmmakers about where the project has taken them so far and what's ahead. That's next.
So there's a family wedding coming up in New Mexico, but a nice hotel can be pricey. If you visit Priceline, get a great deal and go.
Hi, Amanda. Want you to meet your second cousin, Tim. He's moving out your way in a couple months.
Cool. So I guess your mom and my mom.
All I know is we're related.
Yeah.
If you don't go.
I'm Tim.
Amanda.
Whatever's on the line. Priceline.
When you report the weather,
oh yes, yes, yes,
there are two things you can never forget: a sense of adventure and a warm jacket.
Yes,
LL Bean, official outfitter of the Weather Channel.
Listen to that.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi. So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow.
I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Many sleep aids have pain medicine, but ZzzQuil is different. Because why would you take a pain medicine when all you want is good sleep? ZzzQuil. A non-habit-forming sleep aid that's not for pain, just for sleep.
My clear solution for pain, Salonpas Jet Spray, powered by two medicines. Salonpas sprays on clear, dries fast, and provides up to 8 full hours of relief.
Salonpas, powerful relief when and where you need it.
It's your fate.
Lose weight fast with Slim Fast Advanced Snacks. New peanut butter chocolate bites and sour cream and onion chips. Great tasting 100 calorie snacks packed with protein and fiber. Slim Fast Advanced Snacks. It's your thing.
Celebrate the little things, because they're big to you. And that is why you invest. The best returns aren't just measured in dollars. TD Ameritrade.
You know what makes me a weather geek is owning like 5 weather stations at my house, and then I name them. Who does that? Seriously. I did. I named my weather station Albedo.
For you weather geeks, you'll understand what that is.
And then I have Albedo Jr. Don't ask. Join the Weather Channel fan community at weloveweather.tv.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight, low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone, your premier hearing care partner.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
Okay,
you notice this. You can see the visibility go way down. The wind was going that way. And then you see some of the debris and the branches going another way.
I seen it, like, coming at me.
I just said, God, if it's your wheel. And it turned as I was saying it.
We're piling the snow up. It is adding up here in downtown Buffalo.
It is really going to go from a bad travel day to just a horrendous travel day.
Two days ago, we were frozen like, I don't know. And today, it's rained like, I don't know.
A lot of weather over the last 7 days there. Hey, half past the hour now as Weekend Recharge rolls on. I'm Paul Goodloe.
And I am Jennifer Lopez. Maria has the day off. Well, the wild roller coaster ride that is winter is going to continue this weekend. The temperatures climbing, though, as we head into Saturday and Sunday. But then they're going to spiral down as we go into next week.
And in fact, you're going to want to stay tuned with us coming up at 40 minutes past the hour. This stunning video is part of a film project about America's national parks. The two brothers behind the project join us here in the studio to talk about their work. But first, Jen has a quick shot at what's going on today.
Oh, it may be a great time to be out there and go to some of the parks if you can, even if it's just a city park, because today's forecast looks beautiful across the majority of the country with some nice warm temperatures. We will see a chance for a few showers in places in the south, and then we're all going to be talking about a system that's going to really perhaps wreak some havoc as we head into the beginning of next week. Again, a lot of locations across the country, anywhere from 5 to almost 20 degrees warmer than average. And as far as the rainfall, we'll watch for a few showers, especially late this weekend, coming into the mid-Mississippi Valley, maybe even over into the mid-Atlantic. And then this system is going to lead to the Northeast as we head into next week. Paul?
Well, let's talk about that warmth. We've got spring fever spreading east this weekend. St. Louis, highs in the mid-70s today, about 25 degrees above average. D.C., temperatures low 60s today, 15 degrees above average. And even our nation, New York City, also flirting with 60 degrees today, more than 15 degrees above average, and plenty of sunshine in all places. Let's talk about this warmth here, because it's all because of where our jet stream has kind of meandered, a little farther north, allowing the warmer air to invade much of the southern half of the U.S., while a cooler air to the north. That's today. Tomorrow, the jet stream takes a bit of a dip south, which allows some colder air to infiltrate across the Midwest, but kind of cools you down slightly across the southern plains. But overall, temperatures still stay above average through the weekend, but today should be the warmest day, especially in the state of Texas. Close to 80 in Dallas, 82 in San Antonio, 86 in Lubbock today. Tomorrow, take a few degrees off of this. So we're talking about low 70s in Dallas, upper 70s in San Antonio. Houston still in the low 80s both Saturday and Sunday for you. Meanwhile, across the central U.S. and the northern plains and Midwest here in Great Lakes, temperatures are good. 15 degrees above average today, 30s and 40s, even 75 in St. Louis. Although the jet stream dips a little farther south, colder air comes in for your Sunday, dropping to the mid-50s in St. Louis and dropping to about average, which is the upper 30s in Chicago as we head on towards your Sunday afternoon. Even Minneapolis, 35 degrees for your Sunday afternoon. Cooler tomorrow versus today. But it's not just the Midwest and the central U.S. experiencing warm air, Jen. The Northeast also above average today.
That's right. In fact, we're already into the 40s, where normally we won't even get into the 40s unless we're way into the afternoon. But look at 49 in New York, 45 into Boston. Also, we've seen those middle 40s in Washington, D.C. There's still some of that cool air trapped into northern New England. We've been dealing with a little bit of light snow going across this area as well, but a lot of it is not even reaching the ground, and most of it is going to be moving out of here. Notice your highs today. 60 degrees in Washington, D.C., close to it into New York, and low 50s around eastern Massachusetts. Tomorrow, though, they drop a little bit. So try to get outside today and do something, because those temperatures will be a little bit cooler by your Sunday, where the highs will not be quite so much into the 50s. In fact, if I can get Sunday up here we go. We see 49 into Boston, to 50 in New York, to the upper 40s around Pittsburgh. And there, D.C., still mild, still above average, but not quite as picture perfect as what we're expecting for today. Paul?
Now, the big question, our next storm we're watching, will we see much more wet weather or much more wintry weather with it? It really depends on where you are and also what model you believe. And the models right now, well, it's hard to believe them because they're still all over the place. Let's talk about what we're talking about and show you our first storm system. We'll bring some scattered showers across southeast later on this weekend. But again, the cold air with our jet stream kind of dipping a little farther south, that's the important player with our second storm system coming along. How much cold air will take in play with this system depending on how far west or how far east it goes? So that's the million-dollar question we're trying to answer here. And unlike previous winter storms, the model runs aren't really picking up on this consistently in terms of a good solution with this. So right now, look at the U.S. model. It has high pressure kind of slowly retreating, which allows the colder air to stick around longer to get more in play with our second storm system. So that one comes across the nation in the Ohio Valley. This will lead to a more impactful snow event across the central U.S. and then slide across the Ohio Valley, Great Lakes, and the interior of the Northeast as we head on towards Wednesday, Thursday of next week. Now, the European model, well, it takes this high pressure and moves it out faster, which means not as much cold air to play into our second storm system, which means we'll see some snow, maybe even some impactful snow, but not as much as the American model is forecasting, but we do expect plenty of rain and some thunderstorms, even potentially severe weather in the southeast with this second system. So that is something we're a lot more certain of. But again, if you look at this map here going from Wednesday and Thursday, we're definitely going to see some snow, some blue on this map. Exactly where that rain-snow line mix sets up and also how much snow sets up, that's the question we're going to try to fine-tune for you. But do know the Midwest will see some snow into this coming week. Jen?
Okay, up next on Weekend Recharge, two brothers are on a mission to raise awareness about our national parks. You'll meet them next.
Boston Market invites you to enjoy a real meal. Delicious homestyle sides prepared daily. Fresh baked cornbread and, of course, our farm fresh, never frozen, all-natural rotisserie chicken. Come on in for a half chicken meal, just $8.49. Boston Market, all good.
No one caters to you like we do. Boston Market, all good.
Eat up, buddy. Don't get it this time. Yeah.
Okay, not too quick.
Don't let go until I say so.
I got you.
Start strong with the lasting energy of 100% whole grain Quaker oats. And off you go.
Hey, need fast heartburn relief? Try Cool Mint Zantac. It releases a cooling sensation in your mouth and throat. Zantac works in as little as 30 minutes. Nexium can take 24 hours. Try Cool Mint Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Love drama? Go on a first date.
My passion is puppetry. Here?
I think we're done here.
Hate drama? Go to cars.com. Research, price, find. Only cars.com helps you get the right car without all the drama.
Over 40, feeling tired, losing muscle and even romantic drive? Man up with Ageless Male. Natural ingredients clinically shown to support energy, promote muscle, and boost free testosterone.
The great thing about Ageless Male is that it works.
Man up with Ageless Male.
Are you powered by protein? Milk has 8 grams to help give you energy to unleash your potential. Start every day with Milk's Protein and Milk Life.
USA Today and Time Magazine named the Ring Video Doorbell top gadget. Why? Because with Ring, you're always home. You can see and speak to whoever's at your home from your smartphone. And with over 4,000 five-star Amazon reviews and an incredibly simple self-install process, Ring is the smartest, most cost-effective way to protect and monitor your home.
Get peace of mind and protect your home with Ring. Available at ring.com and these fine retailers.
I asked my dentist if an electric toothbrush was going to clean better than a manual. He said, sure, but don't get just anyone. Get one inspired by dentists with a round brush head.
Go pro with Oral-B. Oral-B's rounded brush head cups your teeth to break up plaque and rotates to sweep it away. And Oral-B delivers a clinically proven superior clean versus Sonicare Diamond Clean.
My mouth feels super clean.
Oral-B. Know you're getting a superior clean.
I'm never going back to a manual brush.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight, low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
This is a small taste of what our next guests are working on. It's a film project called More Than Just Parks that looks to get people excited about America's national parks.
And Will and Jim Pattis are joining us here in the studios. You are brothers, and you decided to go out and not just go to the national parks, but film them. So what was your inspiration behind this project?
Yeah, so a couple of years ago, we actually visited our first national park, Petrified Forest in Arizona. And coming from the East Coast, here you have lots of trees, lots of green, but the landscapes in Petrified Forest are just stunning. They're unbelievable. And to us, it was, wow, you know, we've got to get out there and share these with as many folks as we can.
And Jim, there are hundreds of national parks across the country. How many have you guys visited so far?
Oh boy, I think it's 28 national parks that we've been to, and we've filmed 6 of them. So we're working up, and we hope to get to all 59 eventually.
All right, and you said that you just came from Zion.
Yep.
So a little bit of uniqueness about Zion. What would you really walk away with going, wow?
You know, the main main thing, when folks think of Zion, they think of the canyon, the main canyon in Zion National Park, which is stunning and unbelievable, but there was so much more to that park than just that main canyon. There's, you know, it's get out to Kolob Terrace, to Kolob Canyon, to some of these other parts. It's spectacular.
And again, these parks, they're, you know, they're elements of the weather, definitely impacts how they look depending on what time of the year you visit. So do you take that into account when you actually go to shoot these parks?
Absolutely. Some of the ones that we've already done, for instance, we went to Great Smoky Mountains in the fall because you get this spectacular blend of colors with the red maples and these oaks and everything. So, and we did the same thing with Zion. You can see the cottonwoods and everything.
Yeah, this guy right here behind us.
Wow. It just looks beautiful. So what has been the response so far that you've gotten while you go and film these places?
I mean, it's been awesome. We get emails every day from folks excited, you know, this is where you should go next, or you missed this, or you should see this or that. So it's been great. You know, it's exciting work to do. One of the big things I think that we didn't even see getting into this is that, you know, folks who are disabled or who financially can't make it to a park, whatever, love it because they get to tour the national parks through our films, and that's really meant a lot to us.
Again, there are dozens and dozens of parks you guys are planned to film, but the ones you've been to already, what's like a special gem? What's like a must-see for people out there, or perhaps one of these hidden parts of these parks you've been to?
Oh, boy. Well, I would say probably the first one that we filmed in Olympic National Park, we went up to, I think, sort of a lesser-known area of the park called Obstruction Point. You take a, you know, crazy gravel road to get there, and you hike out, and there's just miles and miles of trails on ridgelines, and just with spectacular sweeping views, and it's just amazing, and the solitude is just incredible.
It sounds perfect, but I bet the weather is not always perfect right when you arrive. So what is some of the craziest conditions that you've seen?
Yeah, well, actually, when we went out this past summer, we filmed Redwood National Park in California, which is, you know, beautiful. But we actually flew into Seattle to film Mount Rainier. We had done all this research when we got there. A wildfire had broken out in Mount Rainier where you couldn't even see the mountain because of all the smoke and haze. Luckily, we had done research for Redwood as well, so we said, okay, let's drive down to Redwood and film this one.
Quick shift over.
So, looking ahead to 2016 and the rest of this year, what plans do you have in terms of visiting parks this year?
Oh, boy. Well, we're trying to get, I think our plan is to get five or six parks in this year, hopefully, and who knows, maybe more. But we like to keep a running short list of parks that we're interested in doing, where Rocky Mountain has been one that we've talked about and some
other
ones.
We're open to suggestions.
Yeah, exactly. Email us and let us know. Yeah.
On our website, you can see morethanjustparks.com.
All right, so how can people get out there and help support your project?
Well, you know, we sell prints, we accept donations, but the biggest way folks can support us is by supporting the parks and actually getting out there and experiencing these places for themselves. So that's what we encourage folks to do back at home.
Absolutely.
It is on my bucket list to go to a few of them. I just have to get some time.
Yeah, it's a life-changing experience.
Yeah. Great project. Good luck, guys. It's Jim and Will Paltz here. Thank you for coming in for talking this morning. Let's talk about the forecast for perhaps a couple of national parks out there, like Redwood. Could see some rain showers on Sunday, but today looks like a fantastic day, a high in the mid-50s.
I saw the commercials on TV and I largely ignored them. I didn't know what ABC Mouse was. I've already been let down by so many different things that said that they were going to teach my kids and didn't work. But talking to other parents and my social media circles, ABC Mouse just kept coming up again and again. When Summer started ABC Mouse, it was magical. Immediately, she was engaging with it. She was just so excited to get on and learn. It's been an incredible, very fast transformation from a kid who didn't know how to do anything academic to now she can count, she knows her ABCs, she's starting to read words. And when Summer spelled her name without us teaching her how, it was unbelievable. ABC Mouse is so different from every other thing that I've tried. It's amazing.
Building the only truck with the best fuel economy. An award-winning engine. You got that fire. And a 9,200-pound towing capacity. Takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle? That's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Now get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to $2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop! Whoa, whoa.
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Suffering pain and trauma after an auto accident? Call the law team of Lytle, Ryder, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath at 1-800-4-RIGHTS. We'll take on the big insurance companies for you and fight for your rights. Lytle, Ryder, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath.
Its sleek design is mold-breaking. Its intelligent drive systems, paradigm-shifting. Its technology-filled cabin, jaw-dropping. Its performance, breathtaking. It's self-breaking, show-stopping. The all-new GLC. Mercedes-Benz resets the bar for the luxury SUV, starting at $38,950.
Most medical malpractice victims suffer severe injuries. Don't be a victim of medical malpractice. Call Lytle, Ryder, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath at 1-800-4-RIGHTS to discuss your case. We fight for your rights.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early, followed by cloudy skies overnight. Low 63, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Storm is sweeping across parts of the South Pacific. Tropical Cyclone Winston slammed into Fiji with powerful winds and a lot of rain. Storm has broken records. It's now the strongest tropical cyclone in the Southern Hemisphere ever. The first Category 5 storm to ever hit Fiji. But before it came into Fiji, it pounded the nation Tonga, and then it made a U-turn and came back into that island and hit that island again. Here's the latest satellite picture from Tropical Cyclone Winston. Wind still strong at 160 miles an hour. Again, the nation of Fiji is made up of about 300 islands, so it is moving slowly away from that island. And that current path is going to continue as we go through the next few days. The current radar shows a few of those showers certainly still pounding portions or one of the bigger islands of Fiji. But the projected path does continue that westward movement, maybe even a southwest jog, and it weakens slowly, especially as we go out in time down to around 75 miles an hour by the middle of the week. And we really think it's going to continue to be into more of open water here. Year and hopefully not have another impact on any more islands. Paul?
Let's head stateside again, lower 48, watching our next developing winter storm here across the U.S. And I got to throw this out here that our models are not quite in full agreement in terms of what's going to happen. We kind of have a fairly broad idea what's going to happen. It's going to start as perhaps a low off of the east part of Colorado, the Front Range there. Our first storm system moves eastward. That's going to be followed by a second storm system, which again, the first one helps to bring some of the cold air in. And the question is, how far west or east does this second storm trend? And again, if it goes farther west with cold air in play, we could see an impactful snow event here across the Midwest, including you in Chicago. So we're going to watch our first U.S. model take that high pressure slowly to the east, which allows cold air to linger for our second storm system to work on this as a trough develops. And that will bring a decent snow event here across the Midwest. Chicago, talking about you up towards parts of lower Michigan, decent snow for you. Then again, cold, windy on the backside of the system as it moves across the eastern Great Lakes. Now, the European model has this high pressure moving a little faster, so we're not going to bring the colder in as quickly to interact with our second storm system, but this still brings some snow across the area, but it's going to be a warmer system, so perhaps that rain-snow line a little farther west with the European, a little farther east with the American model. That's the big question. Where does that set up? But one thing we do know for sure is by Wednesday, we can see some strong and severe thunderstorms across the southeastern U.S. And then by Wednesday night into Thursday, we're looking at an impactful snow event here across the central Great Lakes. And then pushing eastward as we head on towards Thursday, we'll fine-tune this as we head throughout this week and we have a better idea of where that heavy snow will fall.
Don't miss Founders Days at Pep Boys. Get 5 quarts of Castrol or Pennzoil conventional oil plus a Fram oil filter for only $9.99 after mail-in rebate. And when you buy 3 select tires, you get the 4th free instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
You want to lose weight? Here's some things you should know. Lose up to 3 times more body fat in 1 month than dieting on your own. Weight loss of just 8% can help reduce your risk for heart disease.
Introducing the all-new Turbo 10. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. You'll love it. Money back guaranteed.
Did you know that losing weight on Nutrisystem can help you lower your blood pressure by 7 points in 1 month? Improve your sleep quality by 19% in 1 month.
Lose 7% of your body weight and lower your risk of diabetes by 58%. So you can have more energy, sleep better, and burn more belly fat.
Bust that gut.
My energy level is through the roof.
I sleep so much better.
My doctor is so happy.
Order your 28-day plan right now. With Turbo 10, you'll get delicious meals and 1 week of our all-new Turbo Shakes free, packed with protein and probiotics to help support digestive health and bust belly bloat.
The shakes, so good.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
Plus 1 week of our NutriCrush shakes to crush hunger free.
Forget about fad diets. It's important to have the right amount of carbs, fats, and proteins to fuel your body. And Nutrisystem has everything you need.
Yo-yo diet. Forget about it.
Lose weight fast, have more energy, and get healthy.
I absolutely feel sexier now than I did when I was in my 30s.
I gained energy, stamina, endurance.
Now I'm taking the stairs.
Call or click now, and we'll rush you Turbo 10 today with 14 free shakes. Lose up to 10 pounds in your first month and 5 inches overall. Money back guaranteed.
I owe my weight loss to Nutrisystem, 100%.
10 years later, and I'm feeling great.
Do what I did. Call Nutrisystem and start looking and feeling great today.
Pick up the phone and call Nutrisystem now.
Call 877-920-DIET right now and get the all-new Turbo 10 with 14 shakes free.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready.
Let me get you ready for the day weather-wise.
We've got a lot going on this morning.
Definitely see what kind of pattern we've had.
So start your morning routine with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jan Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
It is a team here at the Weather Channel and an awesome team at that.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Well, good morning, Daytona Beach. A lot of people getting ready for tomorrow's big NASCAR kickoff. There to be raced at Daytona 500. Enjoying some mostly sunny skies right now. Highs near 72 this afternoon. And what about race day?
Well, the forecast looks pretty good as we are expecting maybe a few more clouds by the afternoon. Here's a look at tomorrow's forecast. High temperature gets up to 73 degrees. Perfect weather for watching a race.
And making left turns.
And making that turn again and again and again.
Hey, well, snow is one thing we guard against in winter. Cold is another.
Yeah, but how do animals adapt to the weather? Well, that is one of the wonders of winter, and as Jen Carfagno shows us.
We humans bundle up, heat our homes, and drink hot chocolate to stay warm during winter. But how do animals survive out in the elements? Well, they either hibernate, migrate, or adapt. Hibernation is like a very deep, prolonged sleep during which the body saves energy by reducing its temperature and heart rate. Some hibernating animals maintain body temperatures near freezing and reduce their metabolism by 75%. Animals such as bears, bats, skunks, snakes, and even bees hibernate to survive the cold months of winter. Ever wonder why humans who head to Florida for the winter are called snowbirds? Well, many birds, fish, elk, and other animals travel to places for the winter where they can stay warm and find food food more easily. Some animals stay put and stay active during the winter. They simply adapt to their conditions. For example, weasels and snowshoe rabbits grow new thicker fur that helps them keep warm and hide them from predators in the snow. Other animals stockpile food in warmer months, go underground or inside trees to stay warm, even huddle close together to save body heat. Aren't we humans lucky that we found our own ways to adapt? Stay warm this winter.
All right, well, stay with us. We'll have more on that powerful tropical cyclone.
And also, the next winter storm to affect the U.S. More details on where that will set up next.
Hey, diddle, diddle, the cat and the fiddle. The cow jumped over the moon, then quickly fell back to Earth, landing on the roof of a Dutch colonial. Luckily, Geico recently helped the residents with homeowners insurance. They were able to get the roof repaired like new. They later sold the cow because they had all become lactose intolerant. Call Geico and see how much you could save on homeowners insurance.
So your grandma wants you to visit and help with a few things. But last-minute travel can be pricey. If you visit Priceline, get a great deal and go.
It's perfect, honey. Come to Nana.
If you don't go...
Ta-da!
Oh, that's perfect.
Hey, I'm going to order some pizza to celebrate. What's your social security number? Sometimes I ask.
Oh, it's
2-3-7-2-2
Whatever's on the line. Priceline.
One moment while I search roof repair. Sure, I can call Ralph. Calling Ralph. Looking up vacation rentals in St. Bart's. Okay, here are...
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, cloudy skies, high 73, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, partly cloudy early. Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 76, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.